All options except for giving up immediately are viable options, depending on the situation. So it's always a good idea to do research on the problem that you're working on, because many problems that occur in practice have occurred elsewhere before. So it's likely that there will be some research on this problem, and that can help you a lot, potentially. Of course, you can also try to show NP completeness for your problem, because if you manage to show this, then you know your problem is going to be hard. This is not an excuse to give up right away, but you basically just know what you're dealing with. It's always a good idea to discuss the problem you're working on with friends and experts, of course, because they might have a new insight that helps you. And finally, settling for a suboptimal algorithm, and we're going to talk more about this in later units, can sometimes also be a good option if the stakes aren't high. So for example, Alice working on Vertex Cover, if her company is happy with installing a few more monitoring devices than the absolute minimum, then she can possibly find another algorithm or just maybe even solve it by hand if she wants to. In this unit, we're going to focus on this aspect here, showing you how you can prove NP completeness for a problem. We have already done this a couple of times, but it's worth to practice this technique. And then how you can do some research on your problem. So I'll give you some example problems that often occur in practice so that you know the names, and when you come across them, then you'll have an easier time to find out more about the problem that you're trying to solve.